It's controlled chaos. Stomping the IE and the world on 1050 AM KCAA. NBC News Talk Radio.
Control Chaos, KCAA, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, 102.3 FM in the Inland Empire, KCAAradio.com, W4CY.com, K4HD.com, for all you internet freaks, and, well, who isn't anymore, or is, hasn't been, and also, iHeartRadio, iHeart.com. I'm Gary Garver, how are you? It is a Thursday, and we have a great guest in studio, one of my good friends. He's going to be performing at Haha's Cafe in North Hollywood on Friday. It's an industry showcase show, which we're going to ask Mike what the hell that means. And we were just discussing, it's a great comedian, Mike Marino. Mike, good to see you, yes, my brother.
It's nice to see you. Nice to be back on your show. Nice to be back in Los Angeles.
Do you enjoy being here in L.A.? Because you're in Jersey a lot. You travel all over the country. Do you really enjoy being in L.A., Mike? Don't you enjoy it? Mike usually gets here about, you know, 7:45 to do the show, because we do the show live at 8 o'clock, and Mike's always stressed out before the show because of the traffic scene here in Los Angeles. I mean, literally at 6 o'clock in the morning, there's traffic, people. I mean, if you're on the East Coast or whatever, right, Mike? I mean, it's traffic insane,
you know,
here.
I like coming to California. I have a nice place in Studio City. I'm always happy. I'm always, because I get to leave. I think one of the greatest things about being in California or in this area, Los Angeles, is not California, this is Los Angeles.
Right, difference.
I have the opportunity as an entertainer to leave.
You're so lucky, man. I just want to leave too. I just want to get the hell out of here. There's just too many people here, man. I mean, but Mike got here because I usually get here about 7 in the morning to prep the show and stuff like that, and nobody's here at the building or anything. And then all of a sudden, I pull into the parking structure, and Mike's sitting there doing God knows what. I mean, listening to Ryan Gosling about how screwed up Hollywood is.
Yeah. It was really nice to hear him say bad things about California and the industry, and I get here extremely early because I could sit in my car and I could talk to my friends on the East Coast. I could do some shout-outs to special people like Gary Raffinelli, who's actually chiming in right now.
You're on Facebook Live.
Facebook Live while we're on the show. So we're doubling up on the show, and we're doing what we're doing.
Can I do Facebook Live on my flip phone? I really do have a flip phone, people. People think I'm full of S, but I do have a flip phone. Mike, can I do Facebook Live on my flip phone?
I don't think you can do anything on a flip phone. You can't Google on a flip phone. You can't text on a flip phone.
I can text on a flip phone.
You can do on a flip phone is get in a car accident.
By the way, I can drop this phone right now. Look at people. I'm going to drop my flip phone like that. Look at that. Guess what? It's working. It'll still work. Look, I'll drop it again. Oh, look at the battery. The battery came out and everything. Guess what? No break. Nothing. These are indestructible now. Flip phones are awesome, Mike.
I can tell you right now, that flip phone is not going to get you Facebook Live. And are in Los Angeles, California.
It's not going
right
to get
now.
Me laid either. Imagine when imagine me going to a bar, which I do all the time, and trying to pick up on hot chicks. And I go, give me your number. And they're like, and I go, check this out, man. You know, they look at me. Man, you are a tool, dude. Give me a break, you know. So anyways, hey, Mike, it's great to see you, brother.
It's great to see you, too. You're actually getting some fan mail on my feed right now. Somebody's telling you, Bert Fox, that you need to get a haircut.
I just cut my hair 2 months ago. What are you talking about?
I wish I had hair like him. I don't know what happened to my hair. And listen, we're getting a shout-out to the Wise Guys radio show in New Jersey.
All right.
So the Wise Guys radio show, I'll be back in Jersey the first week of July, so I definitely want to come on the show. And if you guys come to California, you want to be on Controlled Chaos.
Absolutely. Or they can call in. Hey, by the way, Wise Guys, I have a book called Radio Blows. Maybe I can call into your show and talk about how – much radio blows in my career with the Howard Stern Show. Since you guys were there in Jersey?
They're in Jersey, yeah. They got a great show, the Wise Guys radio show, and I go on a lot, and I can't wait to go back on in July and plug some shows that I'm going to be doing in New Jersey.
Great. Now, you're coming out, you're out here for how long? How long are you out here? Because, I mean, Mike travels all over the country, all over the world, does shows on ships and – I love the ship shows.
I do a real shippy show.
Yeah, so anyway, how long are y'all here let's call it Los Angeles, because California is a huge place. And by the way, Los Angeles does not represent California. California is a beautiful place up north, the Central Coast, San Diego. There's just Los Angeles is the pit, really, of California, to be honest with you.
That's right.
It really is.
This is the heart of the
heart of hell.
It's not even L.A. It's Hell A.
Well, that's what I call it. I say I'm going back to Hell A, right?
Hell A.
How long are you gonna be out here for?
I'm gonna be here for about 10 more days. I got a lot of shows to do. I was at the Laugh Factory last night. I'll be at the Ha Ha on Friday night. Then I'll be back at the Laugh Factory in Hollywood on Saturday night. A couple of talk shows. I'm going to go on a few different shows and stuff like that.
That's
then I'm going off to Alaska.
Alaska?
No, before I go to Alaska, I'm going to do one show in Vegas at the South Point Casino.
Oh, cool.
On June 23rd with Dina Martin.
Oh, nice.
That's right. Dean Martin's daughter, Dina.
Dina.
And then I'm going to jump on a cruise ship. I'm going to go to Alaska.
Wow.
And from Alaska, I'm going to drop off in New Jersey on July 1st.
Awesome, man. Cool.
So I get to get out of L.A.
You do. You get to get out of L.A. I'm stuck here, man. I want to leave. I so want to leave.
Listen,
I so want to get out of here.
If you're out there listening, if you're watching my feed, if you're listening to Gary, get us out of here.
Please.
Get us out of here.
Hey, let's take a meeting, and then you can promise me $500,000 to leave, and we'll, me and Mike were talking about this off the air, how crazy, and we talk about this when he comes on the show, how crazy Hollywood is and the entertainment business is, and Mike is telling me about all these deals that people offer him, because Mike performs, and listen, you got to see Mike perform comedy. It is fantastic. You're really one of the best comics I've ever seen. And I'm not just saying it because you're
very much.
And you always get standing ovations wherever you are and stuff like that. But you know, these people come up to you, and I know they do, and because they used to come up to me. I just blow them off now. I just tell them to go. You know, well, I can't say it on the air because Fred Lundgren will send me another email saying don't say that. But anyways, the bottom line is that people come up to you after the show and go, hey, man, let's work together and let's do this deal and you're funny as hell and I've been big fan of yours. And let's get together and have a meeting. Let's have a meeting.
I get promised $1 million every day for the past 30 years. Let's have lunch and talk about how I'm going to give you $1 million.
Let me ask you, when you go to lunch with these a-holes, do they actually pay for lunch or do you have to pay?
I make sure they pay, because when that check comes, I get up and I go to the bathroom.
At least you get a free lunch out of these,
that's right,
these idiots. But the bottom line
is, I don't even want the lunch.
Right?
Leave me alone.
Exactly. You want to be left alone. So I told Mike, and I said, listen, Mike, I'm winding down on my career. I'm like at the end of my career and I'm done and I've done what I've done. And I told him, basically, Mike, you know what? What you need to do, instead of taking a meeting with these guys that are full of you say, hey, listen, give me a one sheet of what you want to do. Okay, send me a one sheet, email me a one sheet, and then send a cashier's check. You don't have to make it out to Mike Marino, right? Just send a cashier's check of how much money you want to invest in me. And then that eliminates the whole thing, Mike. You won't have to deal with any more people because they're all full of crap.
Yes.
Let's be honest.
Well, here's what people don't know. Everybody wants to be in show business.
Exactly.
So they come at you and they go, here's what we're going to do. We're going to invest a lot of money and we're going to do this, we're going to do that, and we're going to do this, and we're going to do that, and everything has been great. Now, if I ever waited for that, I would be behind a garbage truck for the past 30 years picking up garbage.
It is nuts,
which wouldn't have been so bad because I wouldn't have to talk to them anymore.
Exactly. You'd have a steady job.
I'd have a steady job. I'd pick up the garbage, I'd throw it in the thing. I'd pick them up and throw them in the garbage can.
That's what you need to do. You need to throw them in the garbage, because it's just the scene with Hollywood is just crazy, man, because everybody wants to be a star, celebrity.
I never promised anybody anything, and I never delivered. I never delivered. If I say I'm going to do something, I do it.
Exactly.
If I say I'm going to paint your house, I show up with the cans of paint and a brush.
He's still waiting, dude. Whoever, what's the dude's name? He's still waiting for some dude to paint his house.
Return my phone calls. You ever call somebody, they don't answer the phone?
Oh,
they never answer the phone.
All the time.
It's like, it's harder to communicate with people now with all the communication we have than it was when we had a rotary phone.
People don't communicate with
the phone.
Right.
If I call you, Answer the phone. Pick up the phone.
It's so true.
Say, hello. Hey, Mike, I know it's you calling. I can see it's your number. Do you remember in the day when we hit star 69 because we didn't know who you were? And then when you answered, we were like, damn, it's you. Crap. Yeah, right. I should have called somebody else.
You're so right because look
answer your phone.
Hey, by the way, you're right with the internet thing and all this. We have so many ways to communicate with each other, but nobody communicates with each other anymore, right? I mean, honestly, I used to love to pick up the phone and talk to people. Nobody wants to pick up. When I call people, people never pick up. And guess what? Then they'll text me. They'll text me back on my flip phone. And by the way, I still can get text on the flip phone. But it's still, it's aggravating as all hell, right, man? All right, listen, we're going to take a break. It is Controlled Chaos here on KCAA 106.5 FM. Mike Marino performing at Haha's Cafe in North Hollywood this Friday night, Laugh Factory Saturday night. Go to MikeMarino.net. Check it out. You are, if you want to laugh because the world doesn't have a lot of laughter. Does anybody remember laughter? All
yes.
Right, go laugh at the Laugh Factory and the Haha's Cafe this weekend. We'll be back with Mike Marino right after this.
Controlled Chaos, NBC Talk Radio, KCAA, 1050 AM.
Hey, it's Gary Garver, and come join me at the Live Like Kayla first annual golf tournament, which will be held July 11th at the beautiful Crosby Country Club in Rancho Santa Fe, California. The tournament's goal is not only to raise money for the foundation, livelikekayla.org, but to also create a great time for the participants, sponsors, and celebrities. The Live Like Kayla Foundation is nonprofit for the sole purpose of keeping Kayla Castro's spirit alive and to impact communities that will inspire a positive social change in the world today. For more information or to sign up and play in Kayla's golf tournament, go to livelikekayla.org. That's livelikekayla.org. Look forward to seeing you out there and having a great time.
Attention, retail business owners and managers. Are you losing sales due to customers with bad or no credit? At Retail Customer Finance, we have the solution. Go to www.retailcustomerfinance.com. That's retailcustomerfinance.com. We will approve all customers. You heard right, all customers, based on their ability to pay and not their credit score. So call us at 323-667-4749. That's 323-667-4749. Open a merchant account today for only $199 a year. But wait, it gets better. As a business owner, you will pay no transaction fees for sale. Don't let another customer walk out empty-handed. www.retailcustomerfinance.com or call us at 323-667-4749.
Hey, this is comedian Mike Marino, and I want you guys to come to see my show live. Get some tickets at mikemarino.net. Log on to tour dates and find out when I'm going to be in your area. Also, watch my YouTube series, Marino 2016, as we transform the series into Hey Marino, only on my YouTube channel, which is Mike Marino Live on YouTube. You can log on to my Instagram and my Twitter at Mike Marino Live. I am Mike Marino, and I appreciate being on the Gary Garver Show every time I'm in the box on Controlled Chaos.
Ever wonder how celebrities get their skin red carpet ready? Look no further than the Fire and Ice Facial from Is Clinical, available at Nina MD Beverly Hills. The Fire and Ice Facial is an amazing clinical treatment designed to rapidly and safely regenerate the skin, reducing fine lines and wrinkles for an envious glow, while smoothing and softening to achieve that ageless face. Excellent for all skin types and ages, Is Clinical's Fire and Ice Facial is a celebrity favorite and provides dramatic results with no downtime, peeling, or side effects. The Fire and Ice Facial is normally $215, but call 310-777-7511 now. Mention this ad and pay only $179. That's over $35 in savings just by mentioning this ad. Don't miss out on glowing and radiant skin from Is Clinical and Nina MD Beverly Hills. For more info, visit ninamd.com or call 310-777-7511. That's 310-777-7511.
This is Gary Garver, and I've written a book called Radio Blows. It's all about my career in the radio business, my time with the Howard Stern Show, and celebrity interviews, my top 10 cool celebrities and my top 10 uncool celebrities. Here's a sample of a couple cool ones. and a couple uncool ones.
Make a citizen's arrest on me?
Yeah, I'm going to take this stuff here.
Yeah?
All right, I'm holding you. Call, yeah. Get the marshal.
Get we'll the marshal.
We'll see who's wrong. We'll see
you
who's wrong.
Get the marshal right now?
We'll see who's wrong.
Are you one of the scary morning people who are going to ask horrible things? You got that look. Are you?
You don't have that look?
You do. You got the look like, watch me do something I would have in second grade.
If you're forced into gay sex, who would you choose?
I don't get forced into anything.
Thanks a lot, Jack.
If you're on a desert island and you had a choice of making love to Pamela Lee or Janet Reno, who would you choose?
That's a question I don't want to answer because my wife might be listening to the show.
Thank you, Mr. President.
Okay, Radio Blows, available now on Amazon, Amazon.com, and Kindle. Radio Blows, if you want to get in the radio business or find out the inner workings of radio, it's a must-read book.
Jim, can I ask you a couple questions?
Sure.
Were you the best running back of all time?
Oh, that's a non-entity. I played. I had a real fine career. I appreciate all the other talent that have passed through the history of the game. And that's kind of a silly question. Sorry.
Is acting hard work?
Well, everything is hard work that's worthwhile, and acting is no different.
Do you regret retiring so young?
That's a negative. I'm very proud I retired at the top of my game. I was 29 years old, MVP of the league, and we played for the championship the last 2 years.
How would you solve the problem in the Middle East?
It's something that I would not dare to think that I'm bright enough to be able to comment on, so I'm just hoping that the people that have the power can understand diplomacy, caring, love, and respect.
Do you hate white people?
Oh, man, come on, son. What station are you from?
Satellite Radio.
Oh, you guys are highly controversial. I don't hate anyone, man. In fact, I'm probably one of the few Americans that believe in all human beings. I believe in a tribal culture, respecting all others, and really take offense at a question like that.
Do you support gay athletes?
I support human beings, whether they're gay or not gay. If it's legal, then it's okay with me.
Did you ever yourself during a game?
What?
Did I ever do what?
At yourself during the game.
What does that mean?
Like, you know, went to the bathroom during a game in your pants or something like that? Not a problem.
Oh, man. I'm finished, man. I'm finished.
Thanks. Thanks. Hey.
Controlled Chaos. 10:50 a.m. KCAA.
The man that Howard Stern fired and said he would never work in radio again. That's right. It's the second coming of Gary Garvin.
Thank you, Fat James. May God be resting your soul and feeding you lots of food. I can see Fat James eating, like, not just like a chicken leg, but a whole chicken, right?
I see James Price in heaven as the buffet king.
Right? He's, yeah, like, he's eating whole animals, though. You know what I mean? It's not like...
Every morning he's there with his angel wings that can't get him off the ground, but he tries. He's too heavy to fly.
Yeah, right? I see James, Fat James. We're talking about Fat James Price, and he's a good friend of both of ours, Mike and mine. And that was the intro that we did. And James, you know,
sadly passed away
about 6 years ago. But he was huge. I mean, he was like 5'6" and about 350 or something like that.
Yeah.
I mean, and I picture Fat James like in heaven, being big fat with these little wings, right? little small wings. They can't get off the ground.
Saddest thing, man. But yeah, imagine he's got these little wings. He can't fly. He
can't fly.
He's got like a sheet around him because they couldn't fit him into a nice little, I don't know, angel
right.
suit.
He's all, it's all stretched out right? with his hat, with his little Fat James hat. You know what I mean? I still have that on my mantle, by the way. That remember his hat that he used to wear.
Is that right? You have his hat?
Yeah, I have his hat. No, it's on my mantle. Cool. No, it's on my mantle in my house, right? With my Buddha. I have a green Buddha, man, you know, made out of ivory. Not ivory, but what's the green stuff? I can't think. Emerald or something like that. Anyways.
I know what you mean.
You know what I'm talking about? I can't think of the name.
It's green.
Yeah, it's green. It's that green whatever. But yeah, it's his hat's on the Fat Buddha man.
What a great guy.
Yeah.
What a great guy.
Yeah, he was a great dude. He's a great dude. All right, it is Control Chaos, KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, 102.3 FM in the Inland Empire. I'm Gary Garver here with comedian Mike Marino. Mike will be doing some shows all week here in Los Angeles. Friday night, I will be down there Friday night.
Yes.
at Ha Ha's Cafe in North Hollywood. It's an industry. Now, when I get the email from you, Mike, it's called an industry. What? Industry
well, what
get together?
Is,
what the
I'm,
hell is?
I'm inviting people in the industry to come and watch the show.
And you're bitching about. Hold on, and you're bitching about people pitching you. All right, these idiots that are pitching you that don't do anything really.
You still have to invite everybody and anybody because you never know what's going to happen. So you invite the industry. You hope they come and enjoy the show, and they'll bull throw you when the show's over.
Right.
But then also you hit the fans so that you got at least a couple hundred people come and watch the show.
Yeah, it's a great show, and check it out. What time does it start?
We're starting at 8 o'clock, the Ha Ha Comedy Club.
Okay.
Yeah, I guess he calls it the Ha Ha Cafe Comedy Club.
Is it? I've known it for years as the Ha Ha Cafe, so it's actually the Ha Ha Comedy Club in North on Lancashire, right?
It's on Lancashire Boulevard. It's right. All new. The place is fantastic.
Yeah, it's
cool.
It's
an A-rated comedy club now. The food is fantastic.
Yeah.
The staff is great. The owners are fantastic. And I like playing down there. So when he gives me an 8 o'clock Friday night showtime and I can do what I want, I'm there.
That's going to be cool. So it's this Friday at 8 o'clock. Check it out. And if you want any more information and check out some of your videos, too, because Mike actually, and I say this on the air all the time, Mike, because people ask me, who do I vote for? And I voted for you for president because you ran for president last
Somebody
year.
Somebody had to vote for me.
Well, I did. I mean, I actually did write you in, if you can believe that. Now, I don't know if my vote counted or not, but, you know, I did vote for you.
I figured I had 11 million people following me. Somebody's got to vote for
me. Well, you got Gary Garber.
I bet you any money there's a lot of people who didn't vote for me or wishing they voted for me right now because I'd have made a great president.
Unbelievable what's going on here in our country. You know, we'll just touch on this guy shot up a softball, well, a practice with these congressional people, you know, the Republicans. It was basically Republicans are going to play the Democrats. Actually, it's going to go down tonight, a charity softball game. This is the only thing they can do together, play softball, which I find ridiculous. But anyways, I guess they were practicing, the Republicans were practicing yesterday morning, and this guy, 66-year-old James Hodgkinson, came out and started gunning down congressional people. You know, I mean, people who worked in Congress. Steve Scalise, one of the head Republicans, is in critical condition right now. And this guy posted all sorts of things on Facebook, how he hates Trump and this and that. I mean, and I don't understand. What do you think's going on in our country, our society, Mike? I mean, we talk about this a lot. Is there any hope for us or what?
I really don't know because you never know which way to lean. Give everybody a gun so they can protect themselves or take away all guns so nobody can commit a crime.
Right.
What do you actually do? And then if somebody does commit a crime like this, maybe we really need to set an example. You shoot, we shoot.
Well, they did. They killed him. I mean, they actually did kill the guy. I was hoping that he was going to stay alive because I'd like to find out what the hell possessed him to do this. I mean, the guy, I guess he was living in his van. He was unemployed. You know, so he was struggling. I guess this cat was struggling with life. But isn't there help for people like this? This is what we need. Instead of arguing and bitching and moaning about, you know, it's this country's so divided to the right and the left and all these different factions and all this stuff. I mean, shouldn't we get together and start trying to help people out?
Well, I don't know. We've got to look at it like this. When we get in a bad mood, when we get thrown all these curveballs here in show business, what do? We get together and we talk it out. We don't beat each other up. We don't shoot each other. We talk it out. Then we have a beer. Or maybe we smoke a joint and then we relax.
Exactly.
I don't know why somebody takes out a gun and shoots somebody else like they're responsible for his life.
Have you ever thought about even doing something that way? I mean, you know, your motto was get the bat. I understand bat, but not a gun.
Well, I don't know. I really don't know. I mean, because so many things do make you mad. You really feel like saying, but if somebody ever came at me with a gun and tried to kill me, I'd try to kill them first.
Exactly.
As fast as I can, as best I could.
Yeah.
If I, like this guy in the Circle K grocery store, a guy goes in there and shoots and kills him. Well, what if he had the opportunity to shoot back? And what if somebody else was in the room, had the opportunity to save the guy? I would do it.
Do you own a gun?
Every time I go into a 7-Eleven, yeah, he died. Every time I go into a 7-Eleven for a cup of coffee after a gig, like 2 o'clock in the morning, it's like my favorite thing to do. It's my wind down. I like to go in there, grab a cup of coffee, maybe say hello to somebody, like I did on the East Coast. If I went into a place, I knew somebody working there. But if I ever saw anybody coming in that looked like they were getting ready to take out a weapon or they were getting ready to hold up the thing, I would almost – this is my opportunity to take out my aggressions. I'll jump on somebody.
Yeah.
Why not?
Well, you know what? I mean, the problem is they probably have a gun. You don't have a gun, and they're going to blow you away. That's the problem with that.
Unless I get that gun.
Yeah, well, I know. I dig it. Do you actually own a gun by any chance?
I have a gun in New Jersey. I don't have a gun here in California.
Really?
I've
never owned a gun. So, and I don't plan on ever owning a gun. I don't want to own a gun because I think that brings you bad juju. You know what
yeah.
I mean? So,
well, I don't own the gun because I have it's my father's gun from when he was a kid. It probably don't really work.
Yeah, I haven't tried to fire it. No, I hear you. But, man, I mean, it's weird what's going on in our society. And maybe this – I mean, I hate to say this, but maybe this is a wake-up call to the Republicans and Democrats to go, hey, man, you know what? Let's stop this bickering and let's stop this crapola that's going on. Let's start trying to work together and get things done and try to help our society out because our society is getting more divided, more divided. You're talking about people are so angry and full of hate. And, you know, you walk around here in Los Angeles or you drive in Los Angeles or you go to the market in Los Angeles and everybody has this scowl on their face. They won't even look at you. You can't even say hello to somebody anymore without them going, why is this person saying hello to me? What's wrong with them? Why are they even acknowledging me? You know, and it's weird what's happening.
You walk around on the street and you smile at somebody, they think you're nuts.
Right?
You can't even say hello, how are you? How's your day? Let me get the door for you.
Yeah, it's crazy. No,
well,
people
not
think
here anyway.
Yeah, no, I'm telling you, people think, you know, not here. I'm talking about Los Angeles. I don't know about back east so much. I mean, if people say, you know, say hello to you, usually go F you, right, in back east.
Which means have a nice day.
Exactly. But yeah, exactly. But here in Los Angeles, it's just crazy. And I grew up here. I was born here, man. I'm a native Southern Californian, and it really is disheartening to somebody that grew up here to see how many people are so mean spirited and negative, and give Los Angeles and the Southern California area a bad name. It is disheartening. We'll take a break and we'll touch more on that. We'll talk about Rodman going to Dennis Rodman's in North Korea. He gave Kim Jong Un a gift. We'll talk about that. We got other things to talk about with Mike Marino, comedian Mike Marino. We'll be back with more Controlled Chaos right after this.
NBC Talk Radio, 1050 AM, KCAA.
And now the mighty Wolfman doth roll up his sleeves and giveth to you the Beach Boy.
Round, round, get around, I get around, yeah, get around.
I now declare that all the fun we're having here is deemed retroactive. That is, it'll negate all the bad times you ever had before, and henceforth, further make all the bad times that might be coming now better.
You're listening to the Wolfman Jack Show.
You're setting fire to your hearts. Oh, I know that it sparks. I know you're just burning with desire and hoping that your Wolfman gonna put out the fire. It's an eagle, baby, new kid in town.
Listen to The Wolfman, Friday and Saturday nights from midnight to 5 a.m. exclusively on KCAA.
Hey, it's Gary Garver, and come join me at the Live Like Kayla First Annual Golf Tournament, which will be held July 11th at the beautiful Crosby Country Club in Rancho Santa Fe, California. The tournament's goal is not only to raise money for the foundation, livelikekayla.org, but to also create a great time for the participants, sponsors, and celebrities. The Live Like Kayla Foundation is nonprofit for the sole purpose of keeping Kayla Castro's spirit alive and to impact communities that will inspire a positive social change in the world today. For more information or to sign up and play in Kayla's golf tournament, go to livelikekayla.org. That's livelikekayla.org. Look forward to seeing you out there and having a great time.
Attention, retail business owners and managers. Are you losing sales due to customers with bad or no credit? At Retail Customer Finance, we have the solution. Go to www.retailcustomerfinance.com. That's retailcustomerfinance.com. We will approve all customers. You heard right. All customers, based on their ability to pay and not their credit score. So call us at 323-667-4749. That's 323-667-4749. Open a merchant account today for only $199 a year. But wait, it gets better. As a business owner, you will pay no transaction fees for sale. Don't let another customer walk out empty-handed. www.retailcustomerfinance.com or call us at 323-667-4749.
Hey, this is comedian Mike Marino, and I want you guys to come to see my show live. Get some tickets at mikemarino.net. Log on to tour dates and find out when I'm going to be in your area. Also, watch my YouTube series, Marino 2016, as we transform the series into Hey Marino,
only on my YouTube channel, which is Mike Marino Live on YouTube. You can log on to my Instagram and my Twitter at Mike Marino Live. I am Mike Marino, and I appreciate being on the Gary Garver Show every time I'm in the box on Controlled Chaos.
Ever wonder how celebrities get their skin red carpet ready? Look no further than the Fire and Ice Facial from Is Clinical, available at Nina MD Beverly Hills. The Fire and Ice Facial is an amazing clinical treatment designed to rapidly and safely regenerate the skin, reducing fine lines and wrinkles for an envious glow, while smoothing and softening to achieve that ageless face. Excellent for all skin types and ages, Is Clinical's Fire and Ice Facial is a celebrity favorite and provides dramatic results with no downtime, peeling, or side effects. The Fire and Ice Facial is normally $215, but call 310-777-7511 now. Mention this ad and pay only $179. That's over $35 in savings just by mentioning this ad. Don't miss out on glowing and radiant skin from Is Clinical and Nina MD Beverly Hills. For more info, visit ninamd.com or call 310-777-7511. That's 310-777-7511.
Do you believe in reincarnation?
No.
No?
No.
Not at all?
Not at all.
Do you believe about...
You know why?
Why?
The Bible says it's appointed unto man once to die, and after that, the judgment. So there's a judgment coming for the one life we live.
F***ing balls.
What? I think you just left me.
Did I?
Yeah.
All right, thank you.
Gary Garver, Jew of the... what can we say that's not going to piss him off? Never mind.
All right, it is Control Chaos, KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5, 102.3 FM in the Inland Empire. I'm Gary Garver. That was Pat Boone saying that he doesn't believe in reincarnation.
He doesn't?
Yeah, Pat Boone doesn't believe in reincarnation.
What does he think? Is he just going to die and hang out with James Price?
I mean, maybe. I mean, maybe he's going to, you know, have a buffet with James. Yeah. I don't know. Anyways, we have a comedian, Mike Marino, in studio. Mike, if you want to see some of your stuff, go ahead, Mike. What's up?
I was going to say, if there really is a such thing of reincarnation, wouldn't it be great that James is actually around somewhere?
Oh, he's here. He's
what
around.
What did he come back as? What
God,
do you think?
I don't know.
He's like a dog somewhere.
Yeah, I was going to say, maybe a, I don't know. Why.
He's
I
a pit bull.
Pit bull, yeah, right.
Yeah. not a pit bull. What's a big pug? What's that called? A dog. A big dog.
Doberman?
A bulldog.
A bulldog. Yeah, he
James
looks like
Price
a bulldog.
Came back as a bulldog.
He probably is a bulldog.
Walking around. Give me some food. Yeah.
I need food. I want to eat. Yeah. Anyways, we have Mike in the studio. Mike's going to be performing all week, right? The Laugh Factory, Ha Ha's Cafe, and you're performing with... a friend of mine, and you actually introduced me to this cat, a great
right.
dude. He was a former L.A. Well, not, I should say L.A. I was going to say LAPD, but he wasn't LAPD. He was L.A. County Sheriff.
L.A. County Sheriff.
And now he's a comedian.
He's a full-time comedian.
It's Cliff Yates on the phone.
Cliff Yates.
Cliff, how are you?
Hey, good to hear from you guys, man. You guys are fantastic. That's why I hang around you. You guys are awesome.
Hey, do you have a contract? Do you have a pitch for Mike for doing something, Cliff? You know, do you have a $1 million?
Cliff, promise me millions today.
I got
please.
$1 million idea for you, man.
Nice. Let's have lunch.
Let's have lunch, and then
and you pay for it, and I go in the bathroom and kill myself.
Slit your wrist, right? Anyway, so Cliff, how you been, man? I haven't seen you in a couple months. What's been going on, man?
This book, it's called Radio Blows. I can't put it down. It's fantastic. I guess it's on Amazon. You can buy it there. I don't know. It's great.
Yeah. Cliff helped publish the book, hey. Mike. Did you know that? My book, Radio Blows, he helped me publish the book.
Well, yes. I think that's fantastic because Cliff is really knowledgeable about things like that. Yeah, he put out his own book.
It's a great book.
Yeah, you actually put out your own book, Cliff, right? You have a couple books.
Yeah, I got Cops, The Truth About Cops, and Why You Should Trust Them, and then Public Speaking for Fun and Money.
Hey, Cliff,
wait a minute. I didn't know about that book.
Yeah, you didn't know about it. He has a book where he tells you how to make money by going up and speaking, you know, speaking engagements and stuff like that.
Oh, you mean
stand-up
comedy?
I didn't want to tell Mike about the book because I learned everything from him. I didn't want to know my foot off the stuff he told me into a book.
Oh, naturally. Oh, that's fantastic. Hey, listen, if I'm going to get ripped off, I'd love to get ripped off by a friend.
Right? It's always better to be ripped off by friends, right? Yes. Isn't it? It's more personal.
Why get ripped off by a stranger?
It's more personal. So you guys are performing at the Ha Ha's Cafe. Mike, who else is on the bill besides Cliff?
Well, we got the legendary Jay Davis going to be hosting the show on June 16th at the Ha-Ha. And, of course, the legend over here, Cliff Yates, that we're talking to, who steals things and puts it in a book. And then we got Jod Sirachi.
All right, cool,
Jod Sirachi, that's Italian fella, part of the Make America Italian Again comedy tour around the world.
Right on, right on. And you just had a tour, Blue Lives Matter, right, Cliff, just recently with a good friend of mine, Roger Rod.
Roger Rod, we were all over New York. We were at the Gotham Comedy Club, and we had all of the finest from NYPD was there. And then we were all through Connecticut, and man, we did a bunch of shows and got a lot of support for police officers. It was great.
Yeah, well, you're former LA County sheriff here in Los Angeles, 30 years, and you made it out without anything bad happening to you, thank God. What do you think's going on in our world, Cliff? I mean, I asked Mike about it. Let me ask you, first of all, who'd you vote for? Well, I know who you voted for. I actually voted for our friend, Mike Marino. You voted for Trump, right, Cliff?
I voted for Trump because he supports the police, so I got to vote for Trump.
Okay, and then let me ask you a question. What do you think about what's going on? Now, I guess he's being investigated for obstruction of justice. All hell's breaking loose with this Russia thing. You're a big-time supporter. You actually went to the inauguration. Do you think this is just a smokescreen where people are just trying to take him out, or do you think any of this is real? Or as a Trump supporter, what do you think's going on? What's your view of it?
Yeah, they're just trying to blow smoke out there. They're leaking stuff. Look at this guy, Comey. I never liked him from the beginning. He was leaking himself. He called his buddy and says, hey, put this out there. Yeah, I mean, come on, this guy's a worm.
All right, so you don't think there's anything to any of this? You don't think Trump's anything bad is happening with Trump? You don't think Trump did anything illegal or tried to influence anything? I mean, as a Trump supporter, I'm asking because I like to get everybody's view on this. I mean, I have my own personal view on it. I'm sure Mike does too.
I do have my personal view.
All right, so first,
absolutely.
What do you think? Do you think it's all BS, or do you think there's anything to it? Do you think there's any substance to any of this Russian hacking? I mean, all the security agencies are saying that Russia tried to hack our election and try to influence the election. You don't think any of this is true, or do you think this is all made up, or what do you think as voting for Trump? What do you think?
Well, like the Attorney General said, it appears that that Russia did something. But obviously, if they had anything on Trump, believe me, they would have thrown the cuffs on a guy already. They would have. I'm surprised they haven't broke into his locker and planted dope on the guy. They'll do anything to bring him down. If they could have already, he'd be gone.
Well, they're doing the investigation right now. Robert Mueller is doing the investigation, and they're basically saying now, I mean, it came out last night that Trump is actually being investigated for obstruction of justice. So
keep in mind, Gary, they're going to say that because then they can come out and say, oh, well, he didn't find nothing, and he actually investigated me. They're going to make it seem like, that's how the government works. You know what I mean?
Right. What do you think, Mike? What do you think about all this stuff
going on? I think the whole thing is a waste of time. How do you investigate each other? They should all get in a room and sit down and guys, listen, let's just talk this out. You're unhappy that you don't have a job. You're mad that I'm the president of the United States. Let's start trying to. I mean, how does Russia influence anything in the United States? What did they do? Send everybody an individual email? Did they say, hey, listen, buy this product? I mean, did they spam everybody?
I get a lot.
No, I never got anything from Russia. Nobody called me and said, hey, Mike, this is what you should do.
All I get is, the only thing I get from Russia is hot chicks trying to date me. You know what I mean?
Say, I don't
hey,
even get
give,
that.
Give me $1 million. Yeah. They're telling me, hey, I'm Olga from Russia. Can you send, I'm lonely. Can you send me $1 million, Mike?
And the only spam I get from Russia, the only influence I get from Russia is that I need to enlarge my penis.
Penis enlargers.
And I just want to know, how do they know?
Yeah, exactly. Hey, by the way, I like Russia. I mean, they got the best vodka on the planet, and I'm a big vodka drinker. So I have nothing against Russia. But hold on. Let me ask you one more question, Cliff, about this, because I know you love Trump. If something does break and they do find something out about Trump and Russia, I mean, will you accept that? Will you accept the verdict of whatever Robert Mueller comes up with as a Trump supporter? Will you accept whatever he finds, yes or no?
Yes, I will accept it.
Even if it's bad, even if they find Trump did something, you will believe that. You will take his word for it. You will not say, oh, that's a bunch of BS and they made it up. You will actually say, okay, they found this, blah, 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 ABC. You'll accept it. I just want to know, because a lot of Trump people won't.
yeah, I will accept it, but that doesn't mean I still won't support him. I'll think, hey, you know, he had to do what he had to do. Obviously, he got elected. He's a president.
All right. I just ask him, listen, man, I love you. And, you know, I feel bad. I mean, you know, Cliff's wife came in here, too. And I guess they went to the inauguration, Mike. Did you know about that? I'm sure you did.
That's amazing that they get to do things like this, Cliff and his wife.
He's got a great life, man. I mean, we're busting our, you know, ass, and Cliff is out there. You know, I thought you were on an island somewhere on the East Coast, Cliff. That's the last time.
He owns his own island.
Hey, yeah, we're actually going to be there. Monday we drive out there, and I want to thank Mike again. He's coming back to upstate New York on the island again for a comedy fundraiser that supports the troops that are suffering from PTSD, and Mike helped raise over $12,000 last year, Mike.
And I just want to say this on the radio that everybody's listening. When I come out to the island, I'm staying a couple extra days. All right, Cliff?
Does Cliff
have
we're
going to have a good time.
So
yeah.
So much fun out there.
Is it? What island is it? What is it? Is it Yates Island? Is that what it's called?
It's actually Elm Tree Island. You could Google Earth it. And actually, I'm hoping by the time I get there, everything's not underwater. All the flooding is going on with Lake Ontario and the Great Lakes. My dock's underwater right now. I got like 5 inches under the doorway, and I'm hoping it gets better.
Yeah. Well, you know, there is no global warming, though, Cliff. I mean, I don't know what's going on.
Yeah, I know. I shouldn't have went down that rabbit hole, man.
Well, listen, man, I want to thank you so much for, helping me publish my book, Radio Blows. You can get it on Amazon. I really appreciate that. And I will see you Friday night at Ha Ha's Cafe. You're doing some comedy with a great comedian, my buddy and your buddy, Mike Marino. So I'll see you Friday, man. I look forward to it. And listen, man,
I'll see you there.
And the bottom line is, man, you can be friends. You can still be friends and have different views. You know, this is the craziness of our society, is that if you you've taken some abuse and you've actually said, hey, I don't even want to post stuff because people get really offended because I supported Donald Trump. There's nothing wrong with supporting Donald Trump or having a different opinion. We got to accept each other's opinion and try to meet in the middle and figure out what the hell's going on here. So
piece of cake. Let's do this like the mob would do it.
What would the mob do?
Well, they would say, hey, listen, do you see it my way? No. Okay, well, you're unemployed and you don't have a job and you disappeared.
Wow, Mike. Okay, well, that sounds great. I'm sure that's happening right now. We can go to North Korea about this, and I'm sure that's what they're doing there.
Well, we'd love to have a sit down with him.
Kim Jong-un. Well, Dennis Rodman is actually sitting down with him, he's out there. We'll talk about Dennis Rodman in a minute. Hey, Cliff, I'll see you Friday. God bless you, man. Be well.
See you Friday. I'm bringing the posse. I'll see you, Mike, Friday, buddy.
All right, great. And Cliff does take a lot of crap for supporting Trump, man. I think it's stupid. You know what I mean? It's ridiculous. It's dumb. We all have to get along here on planet Earth. All right, Control Chaos, KCAA, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM. Gary Garver here with Mike Marino, MikeMarino.net. Check it out. He's got all sorts of YouTube videos.
I sell underwear,
T-shirts. You sell underwear, T-shirts, everything. All right, by the way, I got the Rockstar Clothing T-shirt.
Rockstar Clothing.
Right there. All right, we'll be back after this.
NBC Talk Radio, 1050 AM, KCAA.
Hey, it's Gary Garver, and come join me at the Live Like Kayla First Annual Golf Tournament, which will be held July 11th at the beautiful Crosby Country Club in Rancho Santa Fe, California. The tournament's goal is not only to raise money for the foundation, livelikekayla.org, but to also create a great time for the participants, sponsors, and celebrities. The Live Like Kayla Foundation is nonprofit for the sole purpose of keeping Kayla Castro's spirit alive and to impact communities that will inspire a positive social change in the world today. For more information or to sign up and play in Kayla's golf tournament, go to livelikekayla.org. That's livelikekayla.org. Look forward to seeing you out there and having a great time.
Attention, retail business owners and managers. Are you losing sales due to customers with bad or no credit? At Retail Customer Finance, we have the solution. Go to www.retailcustomerfinance.com. That's retailcustomerfinance.com. We will approve all customers. You heard right. All customers, based on their ability to pay and not their credit score. So call us at 323-667-4749. That's 323-667-4749. Open a merchant account today for only $199 a year. But wait, it gets better. As a business owner, you will pay no transaction fees for sale.
Don't let another customer walk out empty-handed. www.retailcustomerfinance.com or call us at 323-667-4749.
Hey, this is comedian Mike Marino, and I want you guys to come to see my show live. Get some tickets at mikemarino.net. Log on to tour dates and find out when I'm going to be in your area. Also, watch my YouTube series, Marino 2016, as we transform the series into Hey Marino, only on my YouTube channel, which is Mike Marino Live on YouTube. You can log on to my Instagram and my Twitter at Mike Marino Live. I am Mike Marino, and I appreciate being on the Gary Garver Show every time I'm in the box on Controlled Chaos.
Gary.
Yeah.
Hey. You're not going to talk to me? Gary.
Oh, yes. Sorry.
Gary, what irritates you most about yourself?
What?
What irritates you most about yourself?
Nothing.
You ever thought about suicide?
No.
Would you? What?
What a strange question.
She's here all the time, dude.
You can't Oscar category, would you do porn?
Hey, John!
What's happening?
Everything good?
Everything is really good.
Yes.
You're a TV star from a movie star to a TV star.
Yes.
I'm proud of you. You look good.
I feel good, buddy. I'm doing great.
Hey, Gary, would you appear on the Gary Garver Show?
Who?
The Gary Garver Show. Would you appear on the Gary Garver Show?
Never heard of it.
You heard of him? Would you bang Sarah Palin? Hello?
Hey, how are you? You gotta come back with better questions.
You believe in heaven and hell? Well, I think there you have it. I think it's going to end right here. What a great night. You know, Gary Busey pulling off my mic at Night of 100 Stars.
From the four corners of the world, dumbing down his IQ so you can understand him, it's Gary Garver. Now do I hate your
face? All right, it's Control Chaos, KCAA 1050 AM, 106.5, 102.3 FM in the Inland Empire. Gary Garver here with Mike Marino.
I'm still here.
You're still here. For a few more minutes, anyways.
I'm hungry.
You're hungry? Well, man, there's plenty of places to eat here on Ventura Boulevard, Mike. And
if you can find a place to park your car, you can have some breakfast.
Exactly.
So I guess I'll be having lunch.
You'll be having lunch, yeah. Or you'll be going way away from here. All right. By the way, Mike's going to be performing. You're going to be performing at Ha Ha's on Friday. If you want tickets, how do they get tickets for that?
You go to mikemarino.net. You can learn about where I'm performing around the country. And for the Ha Ha, you go to hahacafecomedyclub.com. Pick up some tickets, or you can actually just show up at the door.
Yeah, right? Yeah, exactly.
I don't think we're sold out just yet.
Okay.
But if you come to the door at 8 o'clock on Friday night, you get some tickets right there at the door. It's on Lancashire Boulevard in North Hollywood. It's got a big sign that says, Ha Ha Comedy Club.
Exactly. You can't miss it. It's lit up there. And also, you're going to be performing in the Laugh Factory.
Saturday night is the Laugh Factory in Hollywood. They're starting to show at 7.
Ooh, that's
7 o'clock. It is really early.
Why do they do that? Why does he start it at 7 now?
They start the first show at 7. The second show's at 9 to bump up the midnight show to 11.
Oh, they have 3 shows there?
3 shows. So
they're
basically just trying to help out the middle and the last show from not being too late,
right?
I guess.
Who knows?
Getting on stage at 7:30 while the sun's still out is kind of rough.
It is weird, isn't
it's like
it?
A breakfast show.
Yeah, because usually when you go to the comedy shows, it's about 8 o'clock when they start, right?
I mean, the first show is a good time.
It's like an 8 and 10, right? Usually.
Yeah, 8 and 10 yeah. Usually, but they're trying the 7 o'clock show, which is kind of brutal, but
is it working?
I don't know. It's the first time I'm going to be back.
Oh, really?
Here.
Okay. Well, say hello to Jamie for me. Or don't. All right. Listen, I want to talk about Dennis Rodman for a minute, man. This guy is a nutcase. He's actually the ambassador. He's really like our ambassador to North Korea. You imagine Dennis Rodman being the ambassador. I mean, he's friends with Kim Jong-un. He's over there in North Korea right now. I guess he handed the sports minister a book called Art of the Deal by Donald Trump to give to Kim Jong-un.
You know, I only hope Dennis Rodman is smart enough to say to him, hey, listen, let's not have any political problems between you and the United States. He might be a rat. He might be over going, hey, you know what? why don't you just blow up the United States and I'll stay here with you guys? Well, he's got that look, man.
He's nuts. I mean, the dude dresses a chick. I mean, he's a nutcase. He's a mental case. I mean, that scares the hell out of me that Kim Jong-un and Dennis Rodman are like good friends. He sung happy birthday to Un a few years ago. I mean, the Kim Jong-un basically keeps his people in squalor. I mean, they don't have any electricity. It was funny. I watched 60 Minutes last Sunday, I guess it is, on Sundays always. And they had a piece on this guy who defected from North Korea, you know, one of the head dudes. And you see a satellite image of North Korea, and I guess China's on one side and South Korea's on the other side. And it's all lit up in China and South Korea at night. And then in North Korea, which is in the middle, it's completely dark because there's no electricity there. The guy keeps these people in the dark, literally, you know.
Well, he's probably looking at Dennis Rodman and saying, oh, you're a great guy. This is really great. Let's see if we can't make everything work. Then he goes into his chambers with his crew and he says, okay, here's what we're going to do. Let's take this basketball player, cut him up in 25 pieces, and feed him to the people.
Well, he fed his uncle to the dogs. He probably killed his brother last year.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Did you hear about his brother? His half-brother was, I think he was in the Philippines or something, walking in an airport, and this woman came from behind him and put some, like, cloth on his face, and it was poisonous. It was some sort of lethal poison and killed him. And they're saying, you know, they're saying that, you know, that North Korea did, that Kim Jong-un had his own brother assassinated.
I believe it. I mean, they look like they're crazy.
This guy's nuts, man. He's shooting off nuclear weapons.
Nuclear weapons laying on the back of a school bus going down a paraded street, that's some scary stuff.
What would you do if you're
Dennis Rodman should go over there and go, listen, you know what? I think you're great. And then had Dennis Rodman kill the guy.
Right?
Make him a hero.
It would make
him. You don't come back, but you're a hero.
Yeah, it's crazy, man. I mean, what's going on? I mean, what would you do with North Korea? I mean, as president of the United States, you ran for president, you know, you lost. I'm very upset about that. You know,
yeah.
What would you do to North Korea? What would you do if you could meet with Kim Jong-un? What would be your message or how would you deal with it?
I would sit down with Kim Jong-un and I go like this, Kim, I just want to tell you something. I think you're a great guy. You got a nice haircut. Your friends, your family, everybody's really great. I go, first of all, we're a little nervous about all these weapons that you got. It makes us a little nervous. Now, if you can get rid of a couple of them, you know, then we can talk. If you feel like you can't get rid of all of them or half of them, then, you know, you and I are going to have a problem. And at the end of the lunch, if he says, no, I don't want to back down, I want to keep all the weapons, then I say to him, you know what, you're a good guy. I'm glad that you're going to keep all your weapons. Do what you got to do. And we walk out of there, and they all drop dead somehow. I don't know what happened. We gave him that drug that he gave his brother.
Right, exactly. Let's get some of that stuff.
And then we come back to the United States, and we tell everybody, listen, Kim Jong, you know, he said, yeah, he's going to get rid of all the bombs, but unfortunately, then all his friends died. I don't know what happened, but we got his people are going to run the country. They can't believe we turned the lights on. And now that they got the lights on and they can see, they're like, wow, I can't believe we got all these weapons. Let's get rid of them.
Right, exactly. Yeah. Hey, there's actually a society here. You know what? Maybe we can roofie them like Bill Cosby did to all those women, too. You know what I mean? Knock them out. And
yeah, that's
know,
a good idea. Instead of sending Dennis Rodman, so Bill Cosby, Bill, go talk to Dennis.
Exactly.
Go talk to Kim Jong-un there. Give him some drugs. Have some sex for him. See if he likes it.
Well, maybe we can give him to Rodman to give to Un, and then they can have sex together. Because Rodman, you know, he's sort of a weird cat. Anyways, Mike. We got to roll, man.
All right.
I look forward to seeing you on Friday.
Friday night, baby.
Thanks for coming in on the show. You're always welcome. Always love having you as a guest. If you want to find –
thank you.
Give us your information on how to find all your stuff, my brother.
MikeMarino.net and Mike Marino Live on YouTube, Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook. Mike Marino Live.
And if you've never seen Mike do his comedy show, you have to see it. If you want to get some laughs, because we all need some laughs nowadays.
We definitely need to laugh, man.
I mean, we need to laugh, man, because our society is nutty. You go down there, Ha Ha's, Laugh Factory, check out some of Mike's videos. They're fantastic. Mike, thank you so much for coming in, man.
Always.
And have a nice day. You know, when life gets in your face, Mike, and when a painter doesn't show up to paint, or people don't pay their contracts or offer you money, you know what you do? You tell them to have a nice day.
Have a nice day.
Exactly. All right. Take care, everybody. See you mañana. Who are you to tell me if it's black? Stand. It's innocence, the difference between a boy and a man.
KCAA Loma Linda, 1050 AM, 106.5 FM, and now 102.3 FM.
I'm Jessica Ettinger, CNBC. Major indexes are lower. Tech stocks are dragging the indexes down. The Dow is down.